plot in Spada is more or less a history about rage, about fury, about why people get out from their normal lives and get violent to each other. And also it's about how a common thing, a small thing, can transform a country from something stable and something unstable. Essentially, to put it in short, it's about a series of crimes made by an unknown criminal against citizen from minority of Romas, all those citizens with criminal records. And the idea in the book is to see how a society is reacting in this at this more or less common thing. Of course, a crime is not common things, but what I try to discover in the book is how the institution of the state, how the politicians, how the media, how the secret services, how the normal citizen are reacting in front of this provocation, and how this thing is transformed from a criminal thing, and that's all, in an interethnic conflict. And also, it was a short meditation about what is meaning to be a minority in this era, and how the population always is the population, and I'm talking not the population, but I'm talking the entire society is trying to find a scapegoat, to find a patsy, to find a guilty one, to have explanation for what is happening wrong in their lives. In short, this is the book. It's a book about rage and how rage went in fighting against minorities. An author from an editorialist from Le Point told me write that my book is considered to be rompol, which is considered to be political novel. I consider the novel being a political fiction, which is also starting with a crime area, with a polar in a polar area, but also he is developing the reactions and interactions in political world, because from my point of view, you know, also to put a word of a famous singer, Manu Chao, he said, "Politic kills." And essentially, this is about in my book. It's not only the criminal is the killer, but the entire area of society is the killer, because the killer is much complex than a guy with a sword, a guy with a spada, with a weapon. Essentially, the society, the media, the politicians, the secret services, and all their interests are the killers, the real killers of our society. It's complicated because I'm reading a lot. I must tell that when I was younger I was very strong influenced by what is called magical realism from South America, and all the mixture of politics in normal life, because everything you are reading from South America, starting with Marquez, going to Llosa, going to Sepulveda, going to Brazilians, everyone is writing about politics, but in a very subtle way, because they understood, for my point of view, they understand perfect that politics is everywhere in our lives. And that's why I'm interested always in the novel which recognizes the main importance of politics in the normal man's life. Nobody can hide from politics, especially now in the era of globalization, in the era of internet, in the era of mass communication. It's impossible to hide from politics. And that's why I'm influenced by all the authors which put politics there. I can give you an example from what you're calling noir. It's Tom Robbins with his novel Child 44. It's a novel about Stalinist Russia, but it's a novel about how stupid system and an aggressive system is blocking a criminal investigation. Always politics. Politics is anywhere, and I'm influenced by all the authors which put politics there in their literature.